Now, may I invite Colonel Mohammed Mukhtar of the Maldivian National Defense Forces. He will speak to us on the island nation's perspective, which is very much in Sri Lanka's interest as well. You have the floor, sir.
Thank you. Vice Chancellor General Meenal Peeris, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and a very good afternoon. First and foremost, it gives me a great pleasure to be present here at this important and beneficial research conference. And I would like to thank you, KDU and its faculties, for extending the invitation for the Maldives National Defense Force to present an island nation's perspective in this conference. My primary objective is to give you some information about my nation and the roles it played in strengthening first and foremost defense sector in particular, and how these measures truly contributed towards achieving our national objectives. For many of my Sri Lankan friends, of course, Maldives is not new, but for other invitees and guests, I would like to give a snapshot of Maldives. Maldives is an archipelago of 1192 islands, which scattered in an area of 115,300 square kilometers. The land space is just 300 square kilometers of that area. And 192 islands are inhabited, across which we have varying populations in those islands. The total of our population is 340,000 as of now. However, though the country is small, but we also do face different challenges. And throughout our history, each respective government have taken steps to enhance the professionalism of the armed forces to better engage in a contributory manner to national development, harmony, and stability. Therefore, the purpose of this presentation, I will be discussing on the historical state of the armed forces in Maldives, political changes in the Maldives, and role of the armed forces, governance of the armed forces, and its impact on the professional, non-political institute, and finally, structure and civilian control as well, contribution of armed forces in achieving the full-fledged multi-party democracy in the Maldives. Although small in nature, as I mentioned earlier, and population, the Maldives is blessed to steer through the road of civilization as a country with a history of professional and patriotic, selfless military leaders. We as a country had our sovereignty challenged many times throughout the known history. However, except for twice, we defended and protected the nation. Historical evidence states that Maldives was ruled by Portuguese from 1558 to 1573 AD for a period of 15 years. And in 1773, the Maldives was occupied by a South Indian king for 4 months. Both these liberators of this occupation showed utmost sense of selfless service to the nation above and beyond the imagination of any civilized in the history, and setting the highest standard for the military leadership of the country. Based on this foundation, historically, the armed forces of the country was mainly responsible for countering any act of foreign aggression towards the sovereignty and territorial integrity of the country. Historical evidence shows that the armed forces, though are fully aware of the existing political situation, played virtually no role in political power struggle of the country. When the Maldives changed from an executive monarchy to a republic, the purpose and role of the armed forces drastically changed to meet the demands and requirement of the nation at the time. As the country gained independence from Great Britain in 1965, the armed forces of the Maldives was used to exercise its authority in maintaining the territorial integrity of the country. As such, the armed forces were deployed to prevent any rebellions or stop revolt as the country proceeded to a full-fledged independent nation. Due to this extraordinary power vested upon the armed forces during infant stage of the country, a culture of power abuse and inappropriate use of force prevailed among the armed forces members, and especially it was in 70s. However, upon assumption of office, President Kayyum brought abrupt changes to armed forces governance, including direct oversee of the forces to minimize and mitigate the culture of the power abuse instilled upon them during 60s and 70s. As more democratic institutions emerged in national development, the whole of the armed forces was further separated from internal security matters, and more resilient and trained group of people were dedicated to oversee the rule of law and harmony in the country. Although this newly established police wing in the armed forces was an integral part, their operation and responsibilities were separated from general duties of regular forces. Furthermore, in 2004, the police service was established as a separate law enforcement agency under the Ministry of Home Affairs. The Maldives underwent drastic and rapid changes in the early years of this millennium. The rapid changes in the political structure of the Maldives drew an overwhelming attention to all affairs of the state, including the armed forces. During the critical juncture of the country and its political system, the armed forces had to play a crucial role in sustaining the integrity and safety of the nation. As democratic reforms were introduced at an extremely rapid form from around 2004 onwards, it brought about a revolutionary change to all aspects of society and state affairs. The pace of these rapid changes resulted in a situation where a country which had been experiencing political and social stability for over 100 years was suddenly subject to a highly dynamic and volatile environment. The scenario opened a lot of avenues through which the safety and stability of the nation could be placed in jeopardy and turmoil. Thus, an element of stability was greatly required in prevailing conditions, and it was the armed forces that had to play this vital role. As the country underwent this journey towards greater national development, there were numerous occasions during which the professionalism and integrity of the armed forces were the keystone in maintaining a conducive environment for the progress and development. The introduction of multi-party democracy and the first multi-party election held in 2008 were conducted in a smooth and safe manner, which was dependent greatly on the impartiality of professionalism of our armed forces. In the years following the election of 2008, the country has continued on its path in the infancy of modern democracy and has come across several challenges. The new political system and conflict between the three branches of state ultimately resulted in the resignation of the president in 2012. In an atmosphere of political pandemonium and disorder, the importance of the use of military in an appropriate manner in alignment with the fundamental military values is greatly emphasized based on the outcome of controversial events in this period, especially utilizing the armed forces in situations requiring civil authority and on controversial incidents with other state institutions such as judiciary. Even with these challenges, the country has moved to a stable platform, and volatile situation was diffused greatly due to the role of the armed forces. Further, efforts have been made towards enhancing the role and capacity of the armed forces, including the formulation of key policies such as national security policy and defense policy, which provide guidance to the armed forces and further augmenting the civil authority control over the military. Also, numerous bilateral and multilateral engagements are undertaken, including awareness and education of legal aspects of the armed forces in cooperation with international partners such as US and India. Thus, the long-standing effort to strengthen and develop the armed forces has been great benefit to the nation and its development, and especially in the journey towards modern democracy. The armed forces of the nation has always been structured and developed as a professional institution relevant to the era, starting from its inception to the present day. Thank you, gentlemen, and I hope I didn't put you all into sleep.